during my explanation of meiosis, looking at two different chromosomes, we walked as the pink chromosome and the green chromosome went through meiosis and ended up in four different gametes produced by each meiosis. So these eight nuclei shown here are the products of two different meioses. And we need to discuss the concept of allele frequencies and their relationship to haplotype frequencies. There are two different chromosomes we're looking at here. We've got the green chromosome and we've got the pink chromosome. So we could think about diagramming the percent of all of the eight gametes that have a green chromosome. And 100% of them do. So 8 out of 8, all of these gametes have a copy of this chromosome. And all of the gametes also have one copy of the pink chromosome, and that's what we should expect as a result of meiosis, because every gamete is going to have one copy of each of the chromosomes present in an individual. And Mendel's second law, independent assortment, tells us that there will be two different versions in a diploid of that chromosome. So we could imagine dividing this line representing the eight different, the frequency, 100% of all of the pink chromosomes, sorry, green chromosomes, half of them, 50%, half the width of this line, are the paternal version. And half are the maternal version. So we have four of each of those types of chromosomes in these eight meiocytes, sperm or eggs, shown on the right. And the same is true for this chromosome. Half of those in these meiocytes are going to have the maternal version of this chromosome, and the other half, four, will have the paternal version of that chromosome. These relationships have entirely to do with Mendel's first law, the segregation of alleles into gametes. That is, half of the gametes get the paternal version, or one allele, of every chromosome, and the other half of the gametes, or cells during cell division and mitosis, get the other half, the other allele. So this is the result from Mendel's first law. Mendel's second law, segregation, has to do, or sorry, independent assortment, has to do with what happens with combinations of these alleles from different chromosomes. So of the four different gametes that obtained the pink paternal version, what fraction of those, when you look over here on the right, had the maternal green chromosome? We find that two had that chromosome from mom, and another two had that chromosome from dad. And the same is true when we look at the gametes that have the maternal version of the pink chromosome. Half of them, or two, got the maternal version, and another half, or the other half, or two, got the paternal version of that green chromosome. So in all, if we divide this up, we see that there's an equal distribution of who got the pink chromosome, paternal and maternal, and the green chromosomes. So in other words, we have pink paternal with green maternal, and that's 25% of the gametes. And as we discussed earlier, then pink chromosome paternal, green chromosome paternal, will be another 25% of the gametes. So we're just taking these data from the genotypes or haplotypes of the gametes and drawing them in a graphical fashion. And this is going to help us when we start talking about Punnett squares. That when we draw a line, that line represents 100% of the genotypes of gametes, which are also called haplotypes. And those are because of Mendel's second law. The independent assortment of the green chromosomes and the pink chromosomes at meiosis, we get a particular distribution of haplotypes, combinations of pink and green chromosomes. 25%, 25%, 25%, 25%. The 1:1:1:1 ratio. So again, to conclude, the allele is a version of a gene. And in this case, we're talking about P as the paternal allele, or the paternal version of a chromosome, and M is the maternal version of the chromosome, or maternal allele. And what we're looking at here, when we talk about haplotypes, is the combination of different chromosomes or different genes that are inherited from different individuals. We're going to use all of this information when we start setting up Punnett squares right now.